Hi, so today we'll see experiment number 4 of system software and operating system lab. So the aim of this experiment is design, develop and implement YAC or C program to demonstrate shift reduce parsing technique for the grammar rules E tends to E plus T bar T, T tends to T star F bar F, and F tends to in parenthesis E or ID, and parse the sentence ID plus ID into ID. So already you might have studied this parsing techniques, and in that you might have studied the shift reduce parsing. So how exactly the parsing will take place? So here you have to write a program either in YAC or C. So we have chosen a YAC program. So we'll see a YAC program to demonstrate the shift reduce parsing technique by using the given grammar, and we parse the sentence, that is ID plus ID into ID. So let us see how this can be done. So as we saw, this is the aim of this experiment, that is we have to write a YAC program to demonstrate shift reduce parsing technique by using this grammar, and we have to parse the sentence ID plus ID into ID. So as I told you, you might have studied the parsing techniques, and in that you might have studied the shift reduce parsing, but still we'll just glance it before we'll actually see the program. So the shift reduce parsing is one of the bottom up parsing technique, so as highlighted here. So shift reduce parsing attempts to construct a parse tree for an input string beginning at the leaves and working up towards the root. Okay, so it's a bottom up. Bottom up means it starts from the roots of the tree and it will arrive at the leaves of the tree, and it reaches the root. So shift reduce parsing attempts to construct a parse tree for an input string beginning at the leaves and working up towards the root. In other words, it is a process of reducing, that is opposite of deriving a symbol using a production rule. It is in the reverse case. That is, in other words, it is a process of reducing a string W to the start symbol of a grammar. At every step, a particular substring matching the RHS of a production rule is replaced by the symbol on the LHS of the production. Okay. So in general, you just remember, so whenever we have a grammar in the form of LHS equal to RHS, we have to search for the RHS. Whenever we find the RHS, we have to replace that with the corresponding LHS. It is in simple terms. So next we'll see the program. So as I told you, here we'll be writing a YAC program for this, and as you are aware of the structure of the YAC, so this is the first section, that is document section. So here we have added the C code, so that's why to distinguish that we have the pair of symbols, that is percentage and opening brace. So here we need these three headers, that is hash include stdio.h, hash include stdlib.h, hash include string.h. So here we declare two character arrays, that is char stk of 20. This stk stands for stack. Here in order to write a program for this, we will be using a stack. So to hold the content of stack, we declare an character array here, that is stk of size 20. And we declare one more character array, that is input of size 20. So here initially whatever the input which is to be passed, so here the input is already given, it is ID plus ID star ID. So that input is stored in this particular character array initially. So after that, as and when required, we'll be pushing and popping the elements on this particular stack. So for that we need these two character arrays. So after this, we take these two global variables, that is int top equal to minus 1. This is to deal with the top of the stack, which is initialized to minus 1. And we taken one more variable, the temporary variable I, which is initialized to 0. So this is the C code. So after that, here we'll declare the tokens also, which we'll be using in this program. So the tokens are, the first one is token ID, percentage token ID. So after that, we have percentage left plus and minus. These are the two tokens. Again, percentage left star and slash. These are the two tokens. And after that, again, percentage left opening brace and closing brace bracket. These are the tokens. And already you know that here, instead of using the term, we have used the term left here to indicate the operators are the left associative. And here we know that the token that is defined last will be having the highest precedence. So that's why to preserve the precedence also, we have to define these tokens in this way. So by this definition, these parentheses are having the highest precedence than this these symbols, and compared to star and slash are having the highest precedence than plus and minus. So in this way, we will define the tokens here. So after that, we have the next section, and in the second section, so we have these particular lines. So here, as we have already seen in the second or third experiment, in order to evaluate a particular grammar, that is a grammar of having n number of A's followed by B, so there also we have written a similar kind of program. So the same program is here. Here also we have a grammar which is already given, and you have to just match the RHS, and whenever we find the RHS, we have to replace that with LHS. This is the basic funda behind the shift reduce parsing. So here the grammar is L colon E. So whenever we arrive at the start symbol E, so we have to print as except, means this is the last one, okay, semicolon. So after this, what exactly this E is? So again, to this E, we have again the grammar. So this E may be E plus T, or it is T. So in this case, what we have to do, this we'll discuss later. So you just consider this grammar. So this is one first rule, first production rule, that is E colon E plus T or T. The second one is T colon T star F or F. Third one is F is ID. Here will not consider the parenthesis because already the input is given, that is ID plus ID star ID. So no need to use parenthesis, so that's why we will not consider that here. So this is the programming part here. Here we have added the production rules. So we know that as usual, the program starts its execution from the main function. So this is in the subroutine section, we have added the main function. So as I told you, here we'll be using two character arrays. That is, one is stack STK to hold the stack content, another one is an array input to hold the input, that is read. So just to demonstrate you how exactly this program will work, so I have already drawn the content, how exactly the contents of these arrays will change on a particular paper, and I have just included those things here in the form of the image, just to have the demonstration. So let us discuss these lines one by one. So in the main function, the first line is STK of plus plus top equal to dollar. So already we saw that is, whenever we declared this variable top, we have initialized that to minus 1. Okay. So here initially we have to add this dollar into the array stack. This is the starting symbol which will indicate, when means here whenever you encounter at this, so it indicates the stack is empty. Okay. So whenever you write this stack of plus plus top equal to dollar, this dollar will be added to the stack. So that as I told you, that I have shown here. So instead of this, we'll consider this one. Okay, this is stack. So here, as I told you, so you consider this as a stack array, that is STK of 20. And here, as I told you, top was initially pointing to minus 1. So when you write plus plus top, this top will be incremented plus by 1 first, that is minus 1 becomes 0. So at the 0th position the top is pointing. So stack of plus plus top equal to dollar means this dollar will be added at the stack of 0. At 0th position dollar is added. Okay. So after this we will consider the next line, that is printf grammar is. So in our program, before we display the output of this shift reduce parsing, so we will display the grammar as it is as an output. So here to display that grammar we have these lines, that is printf grammar is, this is displayed, and below that printf will just display the grammar as it is, which are already given in the title of this experiment, that is t tends to e plus t or t. On the next line t tends to t star f or f, on the next line f tends to id and slash n. Okay, so after displaying this, so we have to read the input. So for that we display this message, that is printf enter the expression. So whatever the input expression that the user enters, so we read that in the variable input by using the scanf statement, that is scanf percentage as input. Okay, so here already input is given in the title itself. So the input is id plus id into id. So as it is, that input is read into the particular array, so that you can see here. So this is the content of this input array. So how it is read? So it will consider it's a character array. It is going to read character at a time. So first one will be I, after that D, it is ID. So after that plus, and after that I, again D star I D, and at the end we have the null character. Okay, so in this way the content of input will be read. So after this, here what will be the output of this program? So here the output of this is, if you have solved the problems of the shift reduce parsing techniques, you might be aware of this. So the output of this, the expected output of this is in this way. So it should display, in the first column it should display the content of the stack, in the second column it should display the content of input character array, and at the third column it should display the action taken. Okay. So the output of this, the expected output of this program is in this way. So it should display the stack content, input content and action content. So how these things are written, we will go on discussing one by one. So that's why here, as I told you, here in this way the output should be displayed. So that's why we display those headings, that is first we display the heading as stack, after giving a tab space we display the heading as input, after giving tab space we display the heading as action slash n, means after this whatever the content to be displayed, that is displayed. So after this it will start the actual execution of this YAC program. So for that it will call the YY parse. So we know that whenever a particular program calls the YY parse, first in turn it will call the YY lex. Okay, so here whenever the program calls this YY parse, so it will search for the YY lex and it will start executing the YY lex. So the YY lex is here. So in this YY lex, first we have the statement, that is while input of I is not equal to null. So I is again a global variable which I have already declared and it is initialized to 0. So this I is used to traverse this character array input. So input of I is 0 means input of 0 is not equal to null. Means here this particular while loop is used to scan all the characters of the input character array, because in this input character array already we have read the input. So here to traverse this entire contents of this array, we have used this while loop. So initially I is equal to 0. So it will check whether input of I is equal to input of I 0, that is input of 0 is equal to null. So initially if you see the content of this, so I equal to 0, so it is pointing here. So what is that, what is present in input of 0? It is I. So here the condition is false, that is while input of I is not equal to null, the condition is false. So when this condition is it is not equal to null means it is false. So here it enters the particular loop, while loop, and here the statement will be executed, that is if input of I is equal to I. So as we know, I equal to 0. So this is input array. So input of I is 0, input of I is I here. So the first condition is true. And the second one is input of I plus 1. So I plus 1 is D. So it is also true. So when both the conditions are true, so the corresponding statements will be executed. So here, what are the statements executed? The stack of plus plus top equal to I. Means here we have to add I to the stack array. So that we'll see next. So here, this is stack array. So we have already seen that we have initially added that is pushed dollar, and here the top is pointing to this dollar that is at 0th position. So here to add this I, first we have to increment top by 1, that is plus plus top. So the plus plus top means top will point to the next position, and here the I will be added. So as a result, here you can see on the next figure, that is on the next position the I is added. So after that, again to add D, again the top is incremented by 1, that is plus plus top. So here plus plus top means on the next iteration, on the next position the D is added. So here I and D are added and top is pointing to D. And after this, here stack of top plus 1 equal to null. So just observe here, it is, we are not changing the value of top, we are using the value of top here. Top plus 1 means top is pointing here, top plus 1 means the next one, that is in the next position we add dollar here the slash 0, that is null character, but top is pointing to D only. So after this, here I equal to I plus 1. So we will change the value of I. So I was 0. So now I becomes 0 plus 2, that is 2. Now in the after scanning this D, it will move to next character, that is I is pointing to 2 now. So this is for the next iteration. So this will not be executed now. So after this, it will display the content of here the stack and input by using this particular printf statement. So what will be the content of this particular arrays on the screen? So here it will display this line, that is dollar id. This is the content of stack because we have just now added id and previously we have dollar. So here as we have taken id, so here you can see, so it will display the content of input starting from the position of I. So just now we have updated the I value, I is pointing to 2 now. So it will display, so the content starting from this one, that is plus id star id. Okay, so that you can see here. So it will display plus id star id, and after that action is shift id. So that you can see, the action is shift id. So this will be displayed, and after that it will return the id to the parser. So here whenever it returns, so again the parser will start execution. So now it will come to this particular part of the program, and it will just compare the content of the stack with the RHS of these particular rules. So now the content of stack is id. So it will go on searching for the rules where we have id on the RHS. So yes, we have a rule with the id at the RHS here, that is f tends to id. So whenever it is evaluated, so these statements are executed. So here the statement is stack of top minus 1 equal to f. So here this is stack. And here just now we have added id and top is pointing to d here. So here the statement is stack of top minus 1 equal to f. Top is pointing to d. Top minus 1 means the ith position. At ith position we have to add f. So as a result, at ith position we add f. And here again you see, we are not changing the value of top. Top is pointing to d only. Just in top minus 1 position we are added f. So here, as a result, in place of f, I, the f is added, and after that d we have, and null and point stack is the top is pointing to d. So again after this, again the same thing is carried out. Again it will search for the present stack content, that is f, as a RHS. So it finds this particular rule. Here we have f as a RHS, and it should execute these lines now. So as a result, again the same lines are there. In place of f, we have to add t now. So it is stack of top minus 1 equal to t. So again here also the stack is pointing here. Top minus 1 means the place of f, we have to add t. So as a result, in place of f, t is added, but still the stack is pointing to d only. So after that, stack of top plus 1 equal to null. So already null is there, no need to add. So again it will display the content of these two things. So here also, whenever we replace I with f, it will display the content of this thing, stack and input, and it will display the action as reduce f to d. ID, and here also it will display the content of stack and input, and it will display the action as reduce T2F, so that you can observe here. So previously we have seen that it will display this. So after that, whenever it changes the ID to F, so the content of stack is $FD, the input is this one, and it will display reduce F to ID, so this one. So after that, when it evaluates this, so it will display the content of stack as $TD plus ID into ID, and the action is reduce T2F, that is this one. So after this, you can see that again we it will go on comparing the content of the stack, and here you can see we have T as a RHS, and here for this we have a particular rule, but this will not be evaluated here, because if this evaluates in this way, so if I replace T to E, so T E is the expected one. So this, when you have E on the stack, so that indicates the input is exhausted and we have to accept, but still the input is not zero. When you complete the input, then only we have to arrive at this. So that's why instead of replacing this directly with the T with E, what we have to do is we have to shift the symbol onto the stack. So that's why again it will call the lex. So again the lex part will start executing, that is YYLex, and this time again it will compare the content of the input. So presently what is the input? Input here I is pointing to plus, so it will check whether input of I is equal to I. No, this is false, so that's why this if condition is false. So as a result, it will go for the else part. In the else part, what we have? So we have a direct, that is stack of top equal to input of I. So presently input of I means I is pointing to plus, so this plus is to be added to stack of top. So here stack of top, it is not plus plus top, remember this. So presently top is pointing to D, so here stack of top equal to plus means this D will be replaced with plus. So as a result, the latest content of stack is $T+. Okay, you just remember this. Again the top is pointing to plus now. So after this, again it will change, the stack of top plus 1 is null, no need to add, already it is there. So I equal to I plus 1, now input is updated, the I value, it was pointing to plus, now it will be incremented to next character, now I is pointing to here the I. So after this, again it will display the content of the same thing, and the action is shift symbol, that you can observe here, that is. So after this we have this one. Okay, that is T plus ID into ID shift symbol. So I have just written plus here, but it will not be displayed, it will just display shift symbol. Okay, after that it will again return back to return I minus 1 to the, but I minus 1 is nothing but whatever the symbol you have read, so that will be returned to the parser. So parser, again it will go to this grammar portion, so again it will now start searching for the corresponding content on the stack. So now it finds that there is a matching rule in the RHS for T, so this T is to be replaced with E, so again it will execute this one. So these lines are similar to this one, that is again stack of top minus 1 equal to E, means as a result you consider the stack. So here as a result, again top minus 1, top is here, top minus 1 is this T, so this T is replaced with E. So again we have to display the content of the stack and input, and it will display the message as reduce E to T, so that you can see here, that is after this E plus, so ID into ID reduce E to T. So in this way it will display these things. So after this, the next iteration we have to again shift ID to the particular stack. So that's why what it will do, again the parser is going to call the lexer. So YYLex, again it will start searching, scanning the input, again it will check whether the input is pointing to null. So presently input is where pointing where? It is pointing to this position, that is I, it is not null. So it will check this condition again. If input of I equal to I, input of I plus 1 equal to D. Yes, it is true. I input of I is I, input of I plus 1 is D. Again this condition is true. So again these lines are executed. So already we saw what will happen when these lines are executed. So as a result, again and I and D are added to the content of the stack. So as a result, after this plus, I and D are added. So that's why again you know this, that is plus plus top I plus plus top D, again we have null. Okay, so after this again I is incremented by 2, I equal to I plus 2 now. Okay, so I plus 2 means here, okay, that I plus 2 means here, okay, this is stack, see this one, okay. So I was pointing here, I plus 2 means I was pointing here, I plus 2 means it is pointing to star now. So it will not evaluate this again, it will return to return I, before that it will display the content on this this particular content of this on the screen. So as a result we have this one, that is action is shift id. So it is e plus id, it is shifted. So the input is id and here we have the action as shift id. So again return id means again it will start executing the parser. So again parser will start searching for the RHS on the screen, sorry, on the stack. So here RHS already we know that on the stack we have e plus id now. So it will go on searching for id now. So again as per the same thing what we saw in the previously, so first it will evaluate this f2 id. So here these lines are executed. So in place of I, here f is added. So after this again it will search for f. So it will consider this and in place of it will be this lines will be executed. So in place of f the t is added at top minus 1. So here top is this one, top minus 1 in place of f again t is added. So as this is similar to the previous thing. So after this again now we have a t, and here after this again we cannot evaluate t2e directly now. So again what we have to do is again we have to pull the symbol from the input to the stack now. So for that again this parser will call the lexer. So in this lex part it will again start scan input. So presently in input the is I is pointing to the symbol star. So it will check whether input of I is equal to I. This condition is false, so that's why the else part is executed. In the else part the stack of top equal to input of I. Input of I means I is pointing to star. So input of I is star. So star is added to stack of star is added to stack of top. So what is stack of top now? Stack of top is here after inserting this one, that is here after replacing t. So it is pointing to d. So stack of top equal to star means in place of d the star will come here. So after this null as it is. So after this star again what it should do? So again it should read the next input content. So for that what it will do, the parser will call the lex once again and it will continue the scanning of the next characters. So before that here whenever we add this one, again we know this stack of top plus 1 equal to null, already null is there, no need to add. So I equal to I plus 1, so I is incremented by 1. So I was pointing star, so I plus 1 means now I is pointing to the 6th position, again it is pointing to I. So after that again it will display the content same, again the action is shift symbol. So that you can observe here, that is here the content is E plus T star, the input remaining is only ID, and after this shift symbol. So after this what we have to do, again in the next iteration we have to shift ID to this one. So for that after you return from this, so again the parser will call this one. So in turn because still the while of input of I is not equal to null, again it will compare this one, that is so here it will check whether input of I equal to I, again the same thing. So it is pointing to here, so it is input of I equal to I plus 1 equal to D. So the condition is true. So again these lines are executed, as a result ID is inserted onto the pushed onto the stack. So here again the top is incremented, top was pointing to star, it will increment by 1, I is in added. So after that it will increment by 1, D is added. Okay, so after this again we have ID on the top of stack. So after that here I equal to I plus 2, so I equal to I plus 2 means I will be incremented by 2. So I was pointing here I plus 2 means so 6 plus 2 8. So now I is pointing to 8th position where we have null. So null means here this is the end of this particular input. So what it will do is, so after this, after incrementing the I, it will not check here. So after incrementing the value of I, so again it will display the content. So shift ID it will display. So return ID, return ID means again the parser will start executing this particular part. It will again go on searching for the grammar. So here what it will do, I will directly show it on the content of this tag. So here what it will do, so again this id should be replaced with f. We have the content of stack here. So here so after id, so here d we have, so again it will check whether the id is there. So it will evaluate this first. So again the similar thing. So here top minus 1, that is in place of I, we have f. So here now after this again it will go on searching for the remaining thing. So now you can see the top side, because plus and star, between these two the star is having highest precedence, so that's why t star f is to be evaluated first. So now it will search for this one, that is t star f. Yes, we have a rule here, that is t star f is to be replaced with t. So here if this is the case, so we have to execute these lines. So observe this very carefully, that is, so for this, in order to reduce this, so what are the lines? We have stack of top minus 3 equal to t. So here top is pointing to d, top minus 3 equal to t. Top minus 3 means here this is top, top minus 1 this one, top minus 2 this one, top minus 3 is this one. So top minus, at top minus 3 already we have t only. So what we have to do is stack of top minus 3 equal to t means again this t is replaced with new t. Okay, but very important thing is we have to change the value of top. Top is equal to top minus 3. Top was pointing here, top equal to top minus 3 means top equal top minus 1, top minus 2, top minus 3. So as a result, top minus 3 means now the top will be pointing to this t now. So whenever top is pointing here means, so this remaining content is automatically discarded, that will not be consideration. So after this again what we have to do, top plus 1 equal to null we have here. So we have to add null after this, that is after t we have to add null, and after this again we have to print the content, and action here is reduce t to t star f, so that you can see here after this again after shifting we have reduce f to id. Okay, reduce after that we have reduce t to t star f, and presently we have e plus t on the stack, so that you can see here. So on stack we have only e plus t now. So when we have e plus t, again it will, the parser will check for grammar for this, that is e plus t. Again it finds this one, that is e plus t. Now we have to replace this with e. So for this again these are the lines to be executed. So what are the lines here? Stack of top minus 2 equal to e. So top is pointing here, top minus 2. Here top minus 1 is plus, top minus 2 is e. So here what it will do, so stack of top minus 2 equal to e means here in place of e, again the new e is added. So this old e is replaced with new e. So we have the top value. So top is equal to top minus 2. So top minus 2 means here top is here, top minus 1, top minus 2. So again top value is changed. So top is pointing to e now. And after this stack of top plus 1 equal to null means, so here the null is added. So on top of stack we have e now. So again it will display the content. So the action is here, reduce e equal to e plus t, so that you can see. So here reduce e equal to e plus t. So after this, here you can see on top of stack we have e now. So here after this again it will search for the screen, search for the stack, and on stop or top of stack we have only e. So when we have at the right hand side l e, so here it indicates the corresponding the input string is accepted. So as a result, at the end it will display the accept, and this is the end of your particular program. So here in this way this particular program will execute, and here in this way the expected output is this one. So here also you can see, after executing this program we have added the expected output also. So this one again same thing, that is if the input is not matching, so we have to display the message as invalid expression. So here again we have to first execute the ACK program. So cc y.tab.c, after that .a.out. So as usual the grammar is displayed first, and after that enter the expression, this message is displayed. So we have to enter the expression as id plus id into id. So after that whatever the output I shown there, so the same output is displayed on the screen here. So you just execute this and just check whether you will get the correct output or not. Thank you.